Hi everybody, this is Joe here. I just wanted to show everybody the cards I picked up from the Secrets of Eternity sneak peek we ran at my store this morning. And, you know, I got a pretty good haul from it. It wasn't just a single effort. You know, I traded around a lot, you know, trading off things like L Chains and Ulti Big Eyes, things like that, you know, stuff that I'd picked up over the last few months. I've got some sort of not so good stuff. I'm going to presume that people know what the cards do, so I'm going to sort of glaze over them and then just sort of give my opinions on whether I would run them, whether I wouldn't, why, etc. I picked up a Thunderclap Skywolf and a Skilled Blue Magician. This was one of my friends who'd entered the tournament and pulled these in the packs. It's not something I would have actively traded for, as I don't think these are going to see competitive play anytime soon, and I just don't think they're particularly good. One of the secret rares I picked up was one of these, which is a Wild Monster Appears. Much preferred the Japanese, or the original name, Bolt from the Blue, but hey-ho, you've got to be referential sometimes. I'm not a big fan. I really want to see somebody break it, though. You know, I really want someone to play this and find a way of breaking it. So if you do find a way that makes this actually playable, leave a comment for me, because I'll end up probably running it if you do. I picked up some bits for the new Infernoid archetype, and I think these guys work really well as an engine rather than as a deck in and of themselves. I'm thinking you run the low level guys with their field spell and monarchs. Now their field spell is almost better than Treeborn Frog, because you end up generating a guy every turn to tribute for it, or you can banish it towards an Infernoid, and once you've got one down, that will get you the momentum to have a tribute fodder for pretty much the rest of the game probably. But going back to the cards I picked up a Void Seer, which is pretty much their version of Lance. I wouldn't play this. It probably does get played in the deck it's meant for. I picked up an Eye of the Void, which is, again, probably meant for the deck that it's intended for, but it's not something I would play. It's your special summon one from your hand, ignoring its summoning conditions. Starts the momentum going. Once you've got one out, you can probably get the rest. And another one of the secret rares I picked up was their boss monster, Infernoid Anonku. He's probably a bit too hefty to get out. He's kind of like a Judgment Dragon, but requires so much more. I just don't really like the Infernoid deck. You know, if somebody could show me a deck list or, you know, thing, or could play it with me and then I can learn from it, I would really appreciate it. But I can't see it being anywhere above tier 2, especially not with Vanity's Emptiness still being at 3. Because you can't normal summon them, they have to be special summoned. So, Vanities goes up, what do you do? I picked up a pair of El Shaddoll Wendigo. I don't particularly like Wendigo because I think it plays a defensive role in an offensive deck. But, again, I'm quite happy to be wrong. If someone can show me that it's really good, then great. But at this moment in time, I think that if you'd more often just go into Winder and you'd have to change your deck or use Neph Shaddoll Fusion, which I didn't pick up, to make it when, if I was going to use Neph Shaddoll Fusion, I'd much rather be summoning Grista than her. I picked up a Caius the Mega Monarch. There's a lot of hype around this card, certainly in my locals there is. Lots of people wanted this. Although I would only ever play it if I had already maxed out Caius and needed an extra one, because Caius is pretty hard to beat for a tribute summon monster. You know, if you're going to tribute two guys for a guy, it would need to do something pretty spectacular. However, if you hit a Skarm in a BA matchup or one of the Shaddolls with it, your opponent's going to wince. They're not going to like having every copy of it banished from their entire playfield. I picked up a Metaphys Horus, who, again, lots of people seem to want this. And it's nice to have a generic rank at level 6 Synchro back in the game again. That's not Goyo Guardian. But I fail to see why you would ever make Metaphys Horus over Goyo Guardian, unless you were playing a Pendulum normal deck, possibly, but you don't really run tuners in the builds I've seen for that so far. I'm actually experimenting with Pendulum normals, but I don't run any tuners in it, so I don't really see any use for Metaphys. Getting to the bigger stuff I picked up now, I picked up a Ulti Necroz of Gungnir. Now, the Necroz are scary. They are absolutely terrifying. I haven't seen a deck so consistent, I think, ever. You know, Clefort are really consistent. Necroz are just worrying. Although I'm not sure if Gungnir actually sees play in it. I think maybe as a one-off, because, you know, the discard effect is nice. to protect a guy, but past that, I think all of the other Necroz monsters are slightly more prevalent than she is. But we'll see how that goes. I picked up a Malakoda Netherlord of the Burning Abyss and his ritual spell, Good and Evil in the Burning Abyss. I didn't actually like Malakoda when he was spoiled, but as I've sort of read him, and the particularly the ritual spell, I'm starting to grow on him. The biggest issue he has is that he's not searchable, whereas the spell can be milled by Farfa, I believe it is, one of the new Burning Abyss rares, which is a thing. You could be, it's banishable to search, but if you have a Malakoda out, it's quite difficult to get rid of him. For example, I can see plays happening such as I play a Raigeki on my opponent's BA deck or Malakoda field, and he has a Seer in his hand. Discards a Seer to target a monster for Malakoda's effect. Malakoda then dies from my Raigeki. He then, or the opponent would then, in the chain, resolve Malakoda and Seer. The other way around in the chain. So then Malakoda would activate first, sending a card you control to the graveyard, and Seer would just resurrect the Malakoda again. So I think once you get him out, he's actually pretty hard to get rid of. But I'm not sure I would continue to play him yet. I want to be seen. I want to see how it works. But then the biggest pull I got was my Clefortz. Now, I've been playing Clefortz since New Challengers was released and a little bit beforehand. But I picked up 3 Cephalopod, which I would probably side 1 Cephalopod and 2 Ceasefire against Burning Abyss or Shadow, or anything graveyard heavy that swarms the field, because you could just kill somebody outright with it. I need to test it a bit more, but it seemed pretty good from what I tried. I picked up a Skybase, which I don't really see the point of, certainly not being an ultra rare at least, because if I was going to pick an Apocryphor, I would pick Towers over this thing every time. I picked up probably my favourite card in the set, well, second favourite card in the set, Clefortz Stealth, and I got 2 of them. I've been very lucky and very thankful to those that traded them to me, because the plays you can make with Stealth are just brilliant. You don't, because of the way it's worded, you can just bounce your Scout and just play it again and search more. And because you've tributed for it, you'll then trigger the other card that's worth picking up in this set for Clefortz, Monolith. Having your massive plays end the turn by regenerating your hand just seems unfair. There's so much the Clefortz deck can do now. I'm stunned that they didn't preemptively hit it in ban list, but I reckon come April, we might see a little bit of a change. But my favourite card in the set is this thing, Pot of Riches. It's probably going to pick up the more Pendulum guys get released. It's decent in Clefortz, possibly a bit win more. But it seems pretty good. But again, I've been playing Pendulum Normals for a while for a bit of a pet deck, and I'm really enjoying Pot of Riches in that, because it means you can use your guys for Synchros or XYZ material and then go to the graveyard and you not care. But yeah, that's pretty much everything I got. I'd say I did pretty well out of it, and I'm very pleased with the things I've got. And again, I really want to say thanks to anyone who traded me some of the stuff I got. And I'll be showing sort of a deck profile for my Clefortz deck and probably my Pendulum Normal deck as well. So I hope you've enjoyed seeing what I managed to get. If you wanted to continue watching, feel free to like, subscribe, share, all that jazz, all the stuff you know. And see you guys later.